Hello students, here in this video we are going to discuss the topic nucleus from the chapter of class 9th biology, that is chapter 1, cell fundamental unit of life. Here in this video we are going to discuss about the nucleus. So what is nucleus? As you know, the cell has lots of different component in its cytoplasm. Then if you will see in the cell, there are so many different kind of cell organelles, in which you will see there is a biggest cell organelle found in the cell, and that biggest cell organelle is known as nucleus. So you can define the cell organelle is the organelle which direct and controls all the cellular activity of the cell is known as nucleus. Means the cell organelle which directs and control and govern and instruct all the activities of the cell is known as nucleus, and it is compared as the control room of a factory, because it controls all the activities of the cell. That's why it is compared as the control room of a factory. And this cell organelle was first discovered by the scientist Robert Brown in 1831. And the structure of the nucleus shows that it can be dense, spherical or oval in shape. And now we will see what is the structure of the nucleus exactly is. If you see the nucleus in a cell, then you'll find there are four main components are there in a nucleus. The first one is the outermost covering of the nucleus, which makes the boundary of the nucleus, which separates the nuclear matter from the surrounding cytoplasm, and that is called nuclear membrane. This nuclear membrane is not continuous, it has gaps, okay, and that gaps are known as nuclear pore. This pore is make a pathway to communicate between the nucleoplasm and the cytoplasm, okay. Now if you will see inside the nuclear membrane, you will find there are some fluid is filled inside, and that fluid which is filled inside the nuclear membrane is known as nucleoplasm. Inside the nucleoplasm you will find there is a dense mass of entangled thread, and that thread is known as chromatin network, or you can say chromatin thread, or you can say chromatin material. Okay, now inside the nucleoplasm there is a dense rounded body that is known as nucleolus. So you can say a nucleus has four main components, four main structure. The first one is the outermost boundary of the cell, of the nucleus, and that outermost boundary or layer, or you can say the covering of the nucleus, is known as nuclear membrane. And inside the nuclear membrane there is a fluid filled inside that is known as nucleoplasm, and the thread which is present in the form of entangled mass, and which that thread is known as chromatin network, and a dense rounded body which is found inside the nucleoplasm, it is known as nucleolus. So the nucleus is made up of four main components: nuclear membrane, nuclear pore, nucleoplasm and chromatin network and nucleolus. Now the work of nuclear membrane is to make a barrier between the nucleoplasm and the rest of the part of the cell, and it has gaps in between, and that gaps have work to communicate between the nucleoplasm and the cytoplasm. It is a pathway basically that controls the entry and exit of the substance between the nucleoplasm and the cytoplasm. And the chromatin network is very important. That chromatin network is made up of two substance, or you can say two kind of material. First one is DNA and second one is protein. Okay, and this DNA is very important because it has all the necessary information to govern the activity of the cell. That's why nucleus is known as the control system of the cell, because it has chromatin network, and in that chromatin network there is a important molecule which is DNA, which has all the data and information through which the nucleus governs the activity of the cell. Now there is a nucleolus, dense rounded body inside it, and that nucleolus is made up of nucleolus is made up of RNA, and that RNA is used to make ribosomes. So that's why nucleolus is known as the factory of ribosome. Now at the time of cell division, this chromatin thread become condensed and make a rod like structure, which is called as chromosome. Each chromosome has a centromere, so at the time of cell division this chromatid copies itself and make sister chromatids. During the cell division, because the matter from the parent cell transfer into the new daughter cell, that's why it is necessary to copy the chromatin thread into a new set. That's why this chromatin thread at the time of cell division condense itself, detangle itself, condense itself and make a rod like structure, which is known as chromosome. And that chromosome has all the necessary information and get transferred into the new cell. Each organism has a fixed number of chromosomes, like humans have 23 pairs of chromosomes. Now we will discuss about the functions of the nucleus. The main function of the nucleus is to control the activity of the cell, because it possesses all the necessary information for the required growth and development of the organism. And because of having all the necessary information to control the cell, it controls the growth and the development of the organism. And it governs the cell division. The next very important work or function of the nucleus is to govern the cell division. It controls the cell division. Without nucleus, cell cannot divide. Okay. Now the third one is it transfers the genetic information from the parents to offsprings. Because it has all the necessary data and information in its DNA, that's why it is said that it transfer the genetic or hereditary information from the parent to the offspring, and it controls or and regulates all the metabolic activities of the cell. Whatever the functions, activities and reactions take place inside the cell, they all are governed by the nucleus. So that's why the nucleus is known as the head of the cell or brain of the cell or control system of the cell. Now, on the basis of the presence of the nucleus, in the cell, there are two types of cells. The first one is eukaryotic cell, which has a complete nucleus, means it has nuclear membrane inside. There is a chromatin network. And there is another cell which is known as prokaryotic cell, which doesn't have a proper nuclear envelope or nuclear membrane, and their nuclear material is found freely inside the cytoplasm, and that nuclear region inside the cytoplasm without nuclear membrane is known as nucleoid. So on the basis of the development or presence of complete nuclear region, there are two kind of cells. First one is eukaryotic cell, which has all the developed nucleus and nucleus, and the second one is which is not having the complete nucleus, means it doesn't have the nuclear membrane. So eukaryotic cells are the cells which have complete well-developed nucleus, and the prokaryotic cells are those cells which don't have complete well-developed nuclear region, means they don't have nuclear membrane. Okay, now the example of prokaryotic cell is bacteria and blue-green algae. And eukaryotic cells are example is human, plants, etc.